Okay, as long as I do literally nothing. Wait.
I hear myself on stream too.
Okay, okay, you hear yourself?
I feel good.
As long as I do nothing, we should be good. Alright, and we're just about to start. Okay, let's go. Let's go. And we're just about to start.
Let's get it. Let's get it.
Okay.
It's 5 seconds. Let me see. It's time. Oh, that was so perfect, yo. Oh, it's clean. That's clean. I can hear you. The string?
No,
I'm pretty sure I can. They can hear me. They can hear me. Yeah.
I don't know. Right now, the string JRB.
Wait a minute. Your mic just... Yeah, your mic just cut off or something.
All right, it's good now. It's good now. This is where you were.
Pyra! Sorry, Rex. I couldn't tell you.
Okay, is my mic good over there?
I got an invitation to join the chat!
What? Pyra.
Leave it to me, Rex.
All right. Okay. Is this gonna be another slow character? Okay, you can hear me. Your mic, my sub. On my end.
Genius! You're pretty much owning them, and these are seasoned fighters.
There are no pushovers.
Yes. Probably should have restarted my computer before I started this. God damn. So Pyra for Smash?
Talk about a tight spot. Mithra? Let me handle this.
Oh, okay. What, does she actually like switch into Mithra?
Mithra!
Oh wow.
Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of bad now. Coming through. Lightning.
So, let me check over here. What's happening over here?
Foresight. Okay. You can even use that. Okay.
Okay, so they swap. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. Okay.
Quite the spectacle.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Wait, grumps?
I missed this little buddy. Monday by once a while. Oh, look, our friends are here. And there's a pawn.
You're all mine. I'll lend you a hand.
God damn.
Sure did. With our power. Shulk?
Yo, how long is this?
Well.
Bruh.
Now that you're in Smash, I won't go easy on you.
You're fighting nuts. You forget.
This is pretty interesting, though. Seems like an interesting character.
Wow. Minasan. Hello, everyone.
Okay.
It's been a while. I'm Shinya Takahashi from Nintendo. My
stream looks. And now we need to go to the check.
Last year, we delivered some news through a series of Nintendo Direct mini presentations.
I have no idea what
happened
to
Barnes. However, we haven't been able to present a Nintendo Direct in this style for some time.
Probably should have just turned it. Probably should have like restarted my
computer. I'm happy to share this Nintendo Direct with you all today.
Oh my.
We appreciate your continued support.
Anyways. Yeah, I could turn off audio router.
Okay.
Now, then.
What you just saw was the reveal trailer for the newest fighter in the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game, Pyra and Mythra. They originally appeared in the Xenoblade Chronicles series as Rex's 2-in-1 ally. Please look forward to seeing their moveset in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. This fighter releases in March, so we hope you'll stay
tuned. Pretty soon.
Just a bit longer. Alright, let's continue with our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
Alright, let's see. Now for the interesting Okay, Fall Guys? Kinda late. That's kinda late, but okay. Okay. Nintendo kinda late to this, but... They're really adding this game to the Switch.
Stumble toward greatness when Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout comes to the Nintendo Switch system, summer 2021. You have 22 minutes before the solar system is destroyed.
Okay, it works. Okay.
Venture into the vast reaches of space to uncover the secrets
I'm gonna
left
have
behind
to
by an ancient civilization.
Fix this stuff next time we do this.
You have 22 minutes. After
it's
that,
just my computer.
The
I
sun
think.
Will explode
my computer's
and
too
the
slow
solar
right
system
now.
Will be annihilated. However,
I don't even think
everything
like,
will reset,
I don't know what's
allowing
happening.
You to continue exploring while retaining information you gathered.
Okay.
By repeating these cycles.
What is this, No Man's Sky?
The mysteries hidden in the universe. What messages will you discover?
This is literally No Man's Sky.
How can we prevent the sun from exploding? Why is the solar system trapped in an endless time loop? Find out when the critically acclaimed Outer Wilds launches on Nintendo Switch, summer 2021. Right. Put your sleuthing skills to the test in two classic murder mystery games. Famicom Detective Club, The Missing Heir, and Famicom Detective Club, The Girl Who Stands Behind, two deep cuts from Nintendo history, are coming to North America for the first time. Localized in English and modernized for the Nintendo
Famicom
Switch system.
Detective Club.
Suspense, drama, and twists and turns await at every corner. You'll be on the edge of your seat as you dive into these deep narratives set in Japan. In one game, you'll solve a complex murder case surrounding a wealthy family in a haunted village while dealing with amnesia. But that's not the only case to crack.
Okay. So they're really giving us the story type games.
In the other game, you'll investigate a supernatural rumor after a mysterious death to free students from a sinister nightmare. Interrogate suspects and hunt for clues to piece together these chilling conundrums. Can you figure out who the culprit is before it's too late? Uncover the deadly truth in Famicom Detective Club The Missing Heir and Famicom Detective Club The Girl Who Stands Behind, coming to Nintendo Switch May 14th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. A new age of battles begins.
What is this? this the Dynasty Warriors games? This Dynasty Warriors? This looks like Dynasty Warriors. Yeah. Samurai Warriors. Okay.
The latest entry in the Samurai Warriors franchise is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Okay, okay.
Dive into the history of the Sengoku.
I'm not really like, I don't play too now much shines the spotlight on Nobunaga Oda and Mitsuhide Akechi. This is interesting because I haven't seen them release any of the Warriors games in a while.
Unleash high octane moves in electrifying 1v1000 battles. In Samurai Warriors 5, slashing its way onto Nintendo Switch, summer 2021. The vast world of Fadiel beckons.
Okay.
After 20 long years, Legend of Mana featuring remastered HD graphics is coming to Nintendo Switch. You'll set off on a journey to find the mystical mana tree seen in a dream.
That makes sense.
Before discovering the
makes
world
sense because they already released the other three mana games.
During your travels, you'll acquire special items called artifacts. Place them on the map to bring towns, dungeons, and other lands to life. It's up to you on when and where to place artifacts, as well as how to advance the story. Join forces with characters, each on their own personal quests. Square off against fearsome monsters. Or take a break from adventure. Rest up at home. The music has been rearranged for this enhanced version, and you can alternate between the new arrangement and the original soundtrack. Other features have been added, including the ability to turn off enemy encounters, as well as the new minigame, Ring Ring Land.
Okay.
Legend of Mana will launch on Nintendo Switch June 24th.
Yeah, they already released the other Mana games. I haven't really played much of the Mana games, so... Yeah. It's interesting. Oh, is this Monster Hunter? Let's go. Monster Hunter. Oh, okay, these new areas? Okay. And new monsters. Well, okay. Okay. I see, I see. The Volvidon. Yo, I'm definitely gonna be playing this game once it comes out. It's actually pretty sick. I played the demo, it was actually fire. The Almadon.
Elder, I have important news.
So it's finally beginning.
Go assemble the villagers.
Okay.
50 years ago, Kamuro Village was attacked by the Rampage and Magnum Morrow. Suffered some devastating casualties.
How can we fight against that?
Our hunter's about to face the biggest challenge yet. No! We can't lose this game. Pull yourselves together. Come on, get here.
Let's go, everyone.
Go rampage somewhere else.
Nice.
You listen to me now.
So they still have these, like. I swear they had something similar in Monster Hunter World to this.
Watch out for
they had something similar to this.
Do not let it pass.
Okay.
The Rampage. How long do you think it's going to last?
Yeah, Monster Hunter Rise, let's go.
Hey, Noah, we should start preparations right away. We're here to offer assistance.
Oh. What is, are these costumes or are they actually like partners? March 26th. Okay. Ooh, okay. That actually kinda looks pretty fire.
That was the latest trailer. But like
we need some new stuff. Okay, come on. How much time is it been? 14 minutes?
Stay tuned for the latest installment in the Monster Hunter series.
We need the new games. We need the new games, Nintendo.
Next, please take a look at this.
At this. Better be a new game. Oh, Mario Tennis?
The fairway is open once again.
Bruh.
Tee off in the latest installment of the Mario Golf series.
I mean, Mario Golf? Why did I say tennis?
Study the wind and terrain.
They use the same engine as Mario Tennis, though. This game uses the same engine, clearly.
Enjoy golfing with familiar Mushroom Kingdom characters on courses filled with lush, natural scenery. Use features
Yo,
on
for the meme, I might have
like
to get this game.
To see how your shot will
like, I've never really played the Mario Golf games. I played all of them, like all the different types of Mario games, except like the Mario Golf games.
These features can help you ace your shots.
In terms of golf games, I've only.
In addition to button controls,
I've only played,
you can also use motion controls by holding
like
a Joy-Con controller like a golf club.
Sports games.
Gently swing the controller to have your character swing in the game, letting you easily enjoy the sensation of golfing. On top of all that, there are several modes with new elements that truly bring the heat to Mario Golf, including this one, Speed Golf. Here, it's always your turn. Everyone tees off at the same time, then you'll race through the course to reach your ball. Give it another whack to get it closer to the hole, then keep going. Outpace your opponents to come out on top. Your golfing skills aren't the only things at play. Make use of dashes and special shots to beat the competition. Oh, did we mention story mode? As a
story
main
mode?
Character, you'll start out as a rookie and develop your golfing skills while interacting with various Mushroom Kingdom characters. Level up with experience points earned during matches. Then, allocate points to different stats, allowing you to develop your character however you'd like. You can also use your Mii in versus play. Put your golfing skills to the test when
Mario Golf
Super Rush swings onto Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, I'm telling you, Nintendo, they just thought, like, all right, yo, we use this engine for Mario Tennis. Why don't we just use this exact same thing, just make a golf game out of it.
The latest game in the Mario Golf series adds new gameplay for multiplayer modes, as well as the familiar golf gameplay with easy-to-learn controls.
Bruh.
Please look forward to this game on Nintendo Switch. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Check out these games coming to Nintendo Switch.
Okay. So is this going to be
the
third-party stuff?
World of Pandora and Tales from the Borderlands.
Tales from the Borderlands? For a second, I thought it was actually going to be like the normal Borderlands
games.
For a second there.
Mountain of Cash. Set between Borderlands 2 and 3, this game includes all
just
five
Tales
episodes,
game.
Filled with classic Borderlands humor. Gangsters, bandit lords, and vault hunters are just a handful of the obstacles you'll encounter in this choice-driven narrative.
They got some cameos. I actually never played this game.
Ride when Tales from the Borderlands launches on Nintendo Switch, March 24th. 32 of Capcom's most beloved arcade classics are coming to Nintendo Switch. Rewind gameplay, adjust game speed or difficulty, and select from a variety of display options to relive that sweet arcade goodness. Get 1943 The Battle of Midway for free, then purchase game packs or the standalone Ghosts and Goblins add-on to build your collection. Local co-op play is also available. Scratch that nostalgic itch when Capcom Arcade Stadium launches later today.
I actually don't get this.
Brains! As a zombie,
I don't
you just can't get enough of it. In this action game from Aspyr, you'll build your zombie horde and take revenge on the city by turning humans into your undead allies. Replenish your bodily arsenal of sputum head, gut grenades, and more during your grisly mission.
What happened?
This city ain't no match for
a
dead man. Stubbs the Zombie and Rebel Without a Pulse eats its way onto Nintendo Switch March 16th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What?
It's Travis Touchdown versus Assassins.
Aliens
have invaded Earth. Hold up, is this even the right game? Anyway, after annihilating an entire city.
Oh wait, no more Heroes 3? Finally! I wasn't even paying attention. Come on, what the heck? I was too busy with other stuff. What the heck?
Travis Touchdown. You'll need to fight your way to the top to save the world. Hey, 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 not so fast. To enter each boss fight, you'll have to do some odd jobs around town and earn enough to pay off the entry fee. You'll then face off against a slew of unusual opponents.
Oh, finally they're showing this game. I actually haven't played the No More Heroes games, so this is going to be interesting for me.
With a new and improved death glove, you'll have access to a variety of deadly skills that can be customized and upgraded before each match. The fate of the world is at stake, so get ready to kick some, whatever aliens have that you can kick. Anyway, it'll all make sense when No More Heroes 3 lands on Earth. Or, you know, Nintendo Switch, August 27th. Exterminate demons in...
Alright. Oh, this is a new IP.
As above,
God damn, so I wasn't paying attention. Hold up.
Why do they need assassins in
at least they finally showed me something a bit more interesting with No More Heroes 3. I barely got even to see it. What the hell? Alright. So, what the hell is this? So what type of yourself?
God's judgment has nothing to do with it.
Neon white? Okay. I haven't really seen enough to convince me to get the game yet, but
coming to Nintendo Switch winter 2021.
I don't know.
The DC superhero girls are here to save the day.
What is this?
Hi everyone. My name's
Nintendo. Batgirl. Nintendo. We haven't had a direct in so long. This is what you've given us? Batgirl. Nintendo. What are you doing? What are you doing? Who came to this direct today and they're like, "You know what? You really want to know what we need?" And DC superhero girls.
An Amazonian warrior who wields the lasso. Along with our friends Green Lantern, Bumblebee, and Zatanna, we fight evil supervillains to keep our city safe.
Really?
But we're not just about the supervillains.
This is what they're giving us, though?
We also have our school lives, and trust me, there's never a dull moment at Metropolis High School.
Okay, this one's definitely sleep. I was trying to be nice to all the other ones. No, this is sleep. This one's sleep.
Ooh, maybe take some photos to share on Superstar Post while we're at it.
So far, the highlights of this direct has been... Pyre and Mithra and No More Heroes 3. Just at least something. They finally showed something for No More Heroes 3.
Really bad is threatening the city. No one could have seen it coming. But when justice calls, you can count on us to answer no matter
what. Pyre and Mithra is okay. I was hoping for a rushdown character, but... Alright.
DC Superhero Girls Team Power heroically soars onto Nintendo Switch June 4th.
Oh my... Okay, come on.
Ready the juice cannons and prepare for battle.
What is this, Plants vs. Zombies? Probably is. Oh my. It really is. Okay, this is more sleep, I guess. I haven't really played this game, actually. I don't know. Nintendo, you better be saving a lot of your good stuff for later, because I don't know, man. I don't know. All right, cool. What's next? Come on.
Who will join you in your adventure? Hint, anyone can.
What is this, Miitomo? Or Miitopia?
On a quest to face evil and save faces.
Wait, so isn't this just a port?
Miitopia is coming to Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, it's a port. I have never played this one.
Various roles across the kingdom.
So,
turn your favorite people
really
into your allies, or even make someone the nefarious Dark Lord.
So they're really putting this on Switch?
Makeup has
at least I can say it looks better
game
than what it did on the 3DS.
Clam up your knees and get them ready for adventure.
It definitely looks better.
There's also a new wig feature, letting you go wild with your Mii creations and make them even more fabulous. In the world of Miitopia, relationships are key. So consider spending some quality time with allies to strengthen bonds.
Bruh.
This can give you an advantage during battle. If your relationship is sour, though, things might take a turn for the worse. Whoa! You can have a horse as an ally? That sounds pretty darn good! Care for it, and it'll lend a hand.
You can bond with the horse?
In battle.
Bruh.
Venture with friends and familiar faces in the lighthearted romp Miitopia. Coming to Nintendo Switch May 21st. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. Super Mario-themed items are coming to your island.
Okay. That's a... Let's see what
Mario
they're...
Brothers 35th anniversary-themed items are coming to the Animal Crossing New
Horizons
game.
Okay,
the
Luigi costume, Mark. That's pretty solid, pretty solid.
Familiar items like the Super Mushroom and the Question
Block
can be
ordered in-game as furniture items. You know, just a cool little thing for the 30th anniversary. I guess they did not have enough time for this last year because of COVID. But, okay.
You can also place two warp pipes.
That's pretty cool, though, how you can make all the stuff on it.
Then use them to travel between locations on your island. Hey, why not try recreating the Mushroom Kingdom? A free update for the game launches February 25th. After downloading it, Super Mario Bros. Items will be available via Nook Shopping starting March 1st.
Wait, do you have to pay for it?
Keep an eye on the official Animal Crossing Twitter account for the latest
information. I missed that one. Either way, I think it's cool. It's cool. I haven't actually tried this game yet.
Life on your island.
I was sleeping on this game.
How was that? These collaboration items. All right,
come on, Nintendo. We got like roughly 20 minutes again. Anniversary events. Come on. Come on, Nintendo. Hit me with something.
Speaking of which, last week we had the global launch for the Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury game.
Yeah, I saw that.
I hope you enjoyed that Mario adventure as well.
Haven't got to play that one either. Yo, I've been slacking
next
on my games, honestly.
We have another game to show you.
Okay, wait, another Mario game? Oh, no, I think it's just a random other game. Oh. Okay. Hold up. The 2D series. Oh, are they making a would it be Octopath Traveler 2?
Are these the wages of loyalty? Raised Earth and burnt.
I'm pretty sure the game is called Octopath Traveler, I think. I don't remember. I haven't played this game yet. But I know what the game is.
You are a leader and must be the beacon others look to when the night is darkest.
This seems pretty cool. I don't know why they just talked about Mario randomly in between that. Hold up.
Every last one of us.
I don't know why they talk about Mario in between that.
Far, far away lies the continent of Norzelia. Comprised of three nations and limited deposits of salt and iron. Over these precious resources eventually ignited into a great conflict known as the Salt-Iron War. Though the hostilities ceased with an uneasy truce, decades later the flames of war threatened to engulf the realm.
I have not played the first
again
one, so this could be interesting.
Caught in a tangled, fiery web.
This one seems more story based. The other one kind of felt a little bit more like a create your own adventure thing. This one seems a bit more like a Final Fantasy.
Our benefit, you say?
It looks pretty good.
In this new tactical RPG, battles take place on terrain with different elevations.
Mm-hmm. So I think this one's not going to be tied to the other one. Oh, this one's attack. The range okay. can be extended by attacking from higher ground with long range weapons so you're telling such as bows and arrows.
Flank is susceptible not only to your initial attack, but also a powerful blow from the ally positioned behind the enemy.
What have we here?
Charge into an enemy to send them flying into position for a follow-up attack. We win. Link attacks together by first casting ice magic on the flames to create water terrain. Then electrify the area with lightning magic.
Okay, okay.
It is of the utmost importance to survey the battlefield.
Honestly, in terms of games, this seems interesting. And finally, a new game, like a new game that looks interesting that we haven't seen
yet. Throughout the story, you will be faced with making important decisions in a variety of situations. Utility, morality, liberty. Collectively, your decisions will establish your conviction, affecting how the story unfolds and who will join your cause.
Once more, I would ask you plainly, do we or don't we relinquish Prince Roland to Esdrost?
Critical decisions that may determine the fates of nations are settled by vote on the scales of conviction. Use information you've gathered to sway allies toward your favored cause. The story will significantly change based on how the votes are cast.
So they refuse to relinquish him to us.
Lies! His hand was forced!
As more and more critical decisions are made, your journey may take you down paths divergent from those of other players.
You will see what true
might this game actually looks interesting. This game actually looks pretty sick. So Triangle Strategy. Yeah, Project Triangle Strategy. Okay.
RPG from Square Enix will launch in 2022. Please be on the lookout for more information in the future. After this presentation, a demo version of this game will be available to download on Nintendo eShop. And in the future, we'll conduct a survey to gather player feedback. We look forward to hearing your responses on the demo.
Please look forward to future updates on this brand new tactical RPG from Square Enix. Okay, let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Calling all hunters. Do you have what it takes?
Okay. God damn, so much distractions here. I couldn't really get to focus on some of this stuff. Okay, so a Star Wars game. Okay, so yeah, I was talking about some people and everything. I didn't get to see much of the Pyromithra gameplay itself because I was distracted with a whole bunch of other stuff I had to do. But honestly, the character looks good. I'll try the character like how I try every character.
Free-to-play online game set between
like the only character I necessarily didn't really like the gameplay of out of the DLC was like I'd say Nick Steve. I don't know like how Steve was. Okay, so what? What is this?
Interviews. Take one.
Knockout. No. Don't be what I think it is. Please do not be what I think it is. I don't know what this game is, but please don't think. Please don't be like what I think it is.
Hero.
My line of work. Bullets are constantly whizzing past you.
Flaming longsword, blade of doom.
Just once.
Please be something.
Just once. Not, I'd like to catch one of them bullets.
Not an EA Smash Bros. Please, not an EA Smash Bros.
With this crown, I'm gonna lead my not team an EA to victory Smash Bros. And kick some serious ass.
Please, I beg of you. I beg of you. Not indie. Not EA Smash Bros.
I can catch bullets.
Not EA Smash Bros. Please. Okay. 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 It's still like a crossover game, though. It's like...
Let's find out what sound your face makes!
For a second, that looked like it was about to be an EA Smash Bros. That would have been trash. Either way, this game looks... it looks alright. Like, I don't know. Heads up, Your Highness.
Eat this! Can't believe we're losing to a bunch of dairy farmers. Okay, team. They may have won the battle, but not the war.
Hey, can we redesign our characters? You're not a team if you're not wearing a uniform.
Max, this is a war zone, not a bloody fashion show.
Pass to me. What? Interview's over. Oh, come on, man, one more game.
Bruh. Okay, this is done.
The fight for survival starts now.
All right, I do not know this game either.
Hang on tight, because you're all going to play a little game of fate for me.
From the creators of the Danganronpa and Zero Escape series comes a fight for your life.
World's End Club?
Disoriented and trapped in an underwater theme park, the 12 of you, known as the Go-Getters Club, must now survive this game of fate at all costs.
The art style looks like... What was that one anime again?
Sorry to scare you,
it looks like a. It looks like an anime. The game like, is I forgot canceled. What.
The game is suddenly called off.
The game is canceled. Yo, they about to cancel this game. They about to cancel this game right here. They about to.
Journey across the country.
What?
Side-scrolling action with suspenseful narrative.
What? Wait. So they fake out. They're like, oh, this is gonna be an RPG. No, the game is canceled. It's actually a 2D side scroller.
What awaits you all at the end of your journey? The battle for survival begins in World's End Club, venturing onto Nintendo Switch, May 28th. Wield the powers of Olympus with the physical release of Hades. Hades, the critically acclaimed dungeon crawler and recipient of multiple Game of the Year awards.
Okay,
is getting
Hades.
A physical release on Nintendo Switch. This version comes with a couple of extras to assist you on your journey
Hades,
out of the
Hades
underworld.
Is already on Switch, right? It's just getting a physical release.
The Hades original soundtrack.
I'm pretty sure, yeah, Hades
it's
is already
with
on Switch.
2.5 hours of blood-pumping music composed by Darren Korb, known for his work on previous Supergiant titles like Transistor and Bastion. The second is a 32-page full-color character compendium featuring portraits of the game's vibrant cast.
Yo, I really haven't played this game, but yo, I heard this game's really good since, you know, it's like Game of the Year contenders on like many different things. Yo, it looks pretty
exhilarating
cool.
Action paired with a compelling story.
Yeah.
Escape the underworld
also, for Pyra and Mithra, I hope that, from what I'm hearing, Mithra
Hades
is like a rushdown character, and Pyra is like the more, I guess, like neutral, long-range character. I hope, like, you could just only stay as Mithra, because I just want a rushdown DLC character. I don't want to be forced to play. Like, I'm tired of the super long, normal characters. Like, every character is like that in Smash Bros. Right now. It's kind of getting boring. We've had those type of characters like five of, like, well, four of them in the row now. If we're now we're including Pyra.
Battle skills that are second to none. Wield an arsenal of killer weapons, each offering
actually,
a playstyle
no,
with different
Min-Min,
set of lethal skills.
Byleth,
along with ruthless ninjutsu,
Steve
kind of
counts.
Take down enemies.
Yeah. That's just a lot of just long sword normal characters.
While unleashing fast and frenzied combos.
I wanted an FTC character.
Team up with other super ninjas in your quest to fulfill your destiny.
Oh, yo, is
all previous downloadable
this
content,
Dead or Alive?
What? I
wasn't even paying attention. Well, hold on.
Revel in the intensity of
oh, yeah,
Ninja
I know
it's
Ninja Gaiden,
one
but
dynamic
are that Dead or Alive characters?
Ninja Gaiden Master Collection. Slice
those are definitely Dead
Nintendo
or Alive
Switch,
characters.
Summer 2021.
Okay.
More battles are coming
so
to
DLC
Warriors,
for Hyrule Warriors, Age of Calamity, okay. Okay, like, how much left? We got, okay. Oh, they have they're getting waves of DLC for this game. Okay. Seems solid. I just wish we got DLC for Odyssey, because I swear, if they added like more worlds, that would be sick. I think that's one of the games that I really hope they got it. Soon embark on a journey to restore the crystals. Bravely Default 2. Use the job system to develop your characters and master the brave and deep. Yeah, I was gonna just try the demo soon for this game. Turn-based battles.
Veterans and newcomers to the series can enjoy this brand new story on February 26th. A new trailer for Bravely Default 2 will be revealed following this presentation.
Oh wow.
The game can be pre-ordered.
Okay, so they ain't gonna show the trailer here.
An updated demo is also available.
Why didn't they do that with other games like...
The latest installment in the legendary Ghosts and Goblins series comes to life.
Okay.
As the brave knight new Arthur will unleash weapons, spells, and skills to battle monsters across challenging stages.
It's literally just like the old games. Or the old games. Like, I haven't really played the old games, but like, from the footage, it looks exactly like how you... Like, how the footage from the old games looks.
Barry for defense, Carry for transportation, or Archie for bridges. Ghosts and Goblins Resurrection launches February 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. Eight protagonists. Eight captivating journeys. Saga Frontier has been remastered for Nintendo Switch. Travel through a stunning sci-fi world with any of the protagonists, each with their own stories. With the addition of the playable protagonist Fuse, new gameplay features, exhilarating battles, and a new scenario for the protagonist Acelus, Saga Frontier Remastered is an adventure not to be missed. The game launches April 15th.
Okay.
Apex Legends is storming onto the Nintendo Switch system.
Yeah, we already know about this.
This free-to-play battle royale features a growing roster of powerful contenders named Legends, strategic combat, cross-platform
play, I don't really play much Apex Legends, but like, I occasionally play it sometimes. Legendary Pathfinder skin. I like it more than Fortnite, I can tell you that.
Plus, for the first 2 weeks after launch, earn double XP when you play on Nintendo Switch. Fight for fortune, fame, and glory when Apex Legends enters the fray March 9th.
How's it going so far? There's still a little bit more to show you in today's Nintendo Direct, so we hope you'll stick with us.
Next, we have like roughly 10 minutes left. Come on, show us something. Show us something. Show us something. Okay. All right.
Hello there.
There we go. There we go. Now we're talking. Let's go, AG. Let's go, AG. I know. Yo, okay. Come on. Come on. Now we're talking.
To the Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild game.
Yes.
Unfortunately, we don't have anything to share right now.
What?
We apologize.
No, you're cap. Please, cap.
And we should be able to bring you some new information
this year. At least we're gonna. Okay, so it's definitely not coming out now. It's definitely not coming out now, then.
While you're all waiting, however, this Legend of Zelda game will be coming to Nintendo Switch. Please take a look.
Oh, okay. Oh, let's go. Let's go. Yeah, that's what I'm... Yo, Wind Waker HD is actually so good. Actually, no, Skyward Sword, I mean. Skyward Sword. I saw the sky for a second. Okay, so a Skyward Sword remake. Well, remaster. But are they going to bring Wind Waker HD, though? I saw the sky for a second, but yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot. Wind Waker HD Sky has a little less clouds, but okay, this is cool. This is cool. Like, yeah, okay. Skyward Sword HD. Okay.
What you've just seen is The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD. This game originally released in 2011 on the Wii console, and now it's coming to Nintendo Switch. The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword featured a control scheme in which players would use the Wii Remote.
Oh, so now are they going to get a new control scheme? As a shield. Or are they just going to bring it back?
The Nintendo Switch system, the controls here are smoother and even more intuitive.
Okay, it's still the same type of controls.
And we've recreated the controls for the sword and the shield here by having the player hold two Joy-Con
controllers. So is it like now you...
The Joy-Con controller in your right hand is the sword.
And then now you get the... Okay, then you get the shield with the next hand. Okay. That's cool.
The Joy-Con controller in your left
hand is the shield. I haven't really played much Skyward Sword either, so...
You can raise the shield to block enemy attacks. I might try it.
This one's a more linear Legend of Zelda game, so...
Like using both,
I know some people don't like that, but... It could be pretty cool.
Movements add a sense of urgency and tension to combat. But we've also made it possible to play the game with button controls to ensure it can be played in handheld mode or on the Nintendo Switch Lite system. After mulling over how to assign different gameplay elements to different buttons, we decided to apply the sword motions to tilting the right control stick.
Oh. Okay, that kind of makes sense, actually.
Tilt the stick down.
Because I don't know how you'd be able to do it with buttons.
Swing to the right, to the left, or diagonally.
This should have always been an option in the game. Just tilt the stick in the respective direction. Because not everybody wants to use motion controls. Well, at least now, since motion controls are better, it would be a lot better. Oh, okay. That's pretty clean. Nintendo's kind of going off with these recolors.
The Legend of Zelda Skyward
These
Sword,
recolors are going crazy right now.
The earliest story in the Legend of Zelda timeline details the events around the creation of the Master Sword itself. We hope that people who played the original game on Wii and those playing it for the first time will enjoy discovering the origins of the Legend of Zelda.
All right.
The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword
July
16th. Launches July 16th.
Okay, we're running close to the end. Direct, please, Metroid Prime 4, Metroid Prime 4.
Specially designed Joy-Con controllers will launch on the
game. We're getting close to the end. We're getting close to the end, boys.
Many of you may already know this, but The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword was the last original console
I'm predicting right now, hopefully. That's like the only other game that could get me hyped that they could reveal right now.
However, it gave a glimpse into many features and innovations that would eventually be adopted in The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Using the sailcloth to descend in midair, a stamina gauge that depleted as you scaled walls with vines or ran, even the concept of collecting items to upgrade gear. I hope those of you who've played The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild will give this game a try as well.
Mm-hmm. Seems cool. Since I've never gotten around to playing this game, I might get it. Seems cool.
Please look forward to
I always
like
the art style
Skyward
for this game.
Sword HD.
I just never knew how to feel about the motion controls.
Well, what did you think? The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword has been optimized for Nintendo Switch. It includes intuitive motion controls and button controls by tilting the right control stick. Okay, the next game will be our last
game
for today.
Okay.
Please take a look at this.
Last game. Alright, come on. Something hype. Okay, hold up. Hold on now. Splatoon 3? Okay, Splatoon 3, okay. That's solid. Alright. Oh, and this is like from the whole thing that they were talking about with the story. How in the last Splatfest they had this weird thing with the story. So yeah, this has to be Splatoon 3, yeah. This is Splatoon 3. Okay, so what are they going to do differently this time? Other than, you know, the story. Because now the story is going to be more apocalyptic. Oh, okay. Oh, you have a buddy. Ooh, okay. Bow and arrow. Splat gun, okay. Okay. This is actually nice. This is nice. This is looking nice. So now can we see some of that gameplay? Like what do they change? So yeah, I'm guessing the whole story. I think it's going to be more expansive story for Splatoon, which is going to be pretty interesting. What's the multiplayer gonna be like? I just hope now, since we already know what they did in Splatoon 2, so I just want them to really, like, you know, go ham with this one. Just they do like all sorts of things with this one. Like really try to experiment with the Splatoon formula, because that would be pretty sick. Okay. Yep. Splatoon 3. Is this it? That's it? No, come on, some gameplay, please. All right, there we go. Ooh, okay. I like how they come out like that. Wait, hold up. Okay, so this is gonna be the theme of Splatoon 3, like more like, kind of apocalyptic, like, you know, like desert type area. All right. Oh, you could change weapons. Oh, you could change weapons? Hold up. Oh, this is looking clean. This is looking... Oh, okay. I'm liking the new weapons. Yo, I saw that. I saw that. So you could change weapons now? So you're gonna have a secondary, like a pistol. And then... Yeah, okay. I saw that. Don't think you could flip that past me. Don't think you could flip that past me. Alright, so that's it.
What you've just seen is the latest installment.